That one. Okay. Right, let's just get it started. Ah, typical sync issues. Well, oops. Well, let's give this a crack. Yeah, we are on the right account. Subtitles, please. Why wouldn't I?
All right, I'm ready.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Emmett Brown. I'm standing on the parking lot at Twin Pines Mall. It's Saturday morning, October 26, 1985, 1:18 a.m., and this is temporal experiment number one. Come on, Einy. Hey, boy, get in there. That a boy. In you go. Get down. Get your seatbelt on.
Get your seatbelt on.
Whoa, okay.
Please note that Einstein's clock is in precise synchronization with my control watch. Got it?
Right, check, Doc.
Good. Have a good trip, Einstein. Watch your head.
Why did he send just the doc?
You got that thing hooked up to the car?
Watch this.
Yeah, okay. Got it.
Not me! The car! The car!
That's it. Just play around with your race car.
If my calculations are correct, when this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious shit.
He would never say that. What a load of bluey.
Watch this, watch this! Displacement occurred at exactly 1:20 a.m. and 0 seconds.
Hot Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, Doc. You disintegrated Einstein.
Calm down, Marty. I didn't disintegrate anything. The molecular structure of both Einstein and the car are completely intact.
God, that lip sync's awful.
Where the hell are they?
The appropriate question is, when the hell are they? You see, Einstein has just become the world's first time traveler. I sent him into the future. 1 minute into the future, to be exact. and at precisely 1:21
Yeah, why did you put the dog in the time machine?
We shall catch up with him and the time machine.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You put your dog in a time machine made out of a DeLorean?
The way I see it, if you're going to build a time machine into a car, why not do it with some style? Besides, the stainless steel construction made the flux dispersal. Look out!
Yeah, you're gone fucked up, haven't you?
Doc?
Huh, that's peculiar.
Where's the car, Doc?
It should have caught up with us 27 seconds ago.
Doc, what happened, Einstein?
No need for concern. It's probably just a minor miscalibration of the time circuit. Marty, could you get my notebook? It should be in the toolbox.
Crazy fool when I'm fucked up.
Notebook. Got it. Flux capacitor?
That's it!
What the heck's a flux capacitor?
My latest invention. The thing that makes time travel possible. In this notebook, I've detailed the nearly 3 decades of scientific breakthroughs necessary to build a working time machine. If it ever fell into the wrong hands,
you've
the
just in the car somewhere.
Catastrophic.
What were you expecting?
Let's see. Is mass equals I times Z, and
consequences could be catastrophic? Whoa. Deja vu. Doc?
Great Scott!
Doc, what is it?
I've made a horrible mistake!
Doc! No!
I'm sorry, Marty.
Doc, come back! Doc!
How's sending your dog into the future gonna affect the past?
Doc!
Oh. It's a dream. What a surprise.
Marty, is everything okay?
Hey, what do you think?
Yeah, Mom, it was just a nightmare.
Oh, you mind?
I was in the past and Doc was there.
Well, you're safe and sound now. Back in good old 1986.
1986?
But you'd better get up. Your father's waiting for you.
Huh?
Weren't you going to meet him over at Doc's?
Holy crap, I'm late!
It's about time.
Dad, are we too late to stop the sale?
Better late than never. You wouldn't believe how much rare stuff there is back here.
That's Doc stuff. The city has no right
to. Now, son, I know you're upset, but your friend's been gone for months, and the city really seems hell-bent on using his land for that new parking garage. And hey, is that a first edition Jules Verne?
It's just not fair. But at least things can't
get any
worse.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
Hey, Marty.
Hi,
Biff Tannen.
Come to see if the old crackpot had any buried treasure? Nah, I guess I'm just... remembering.
Don't send the dog to the future.
Hey, let me!
Now, Biff, leave Marty alone. This is a very emotional
time
for him.
He's a big lumbering
oaf. Oh, sure. Sorry, Marty.
I see they went all out on getting the correct sounding voice actors. Wow, that was amazing. Whatever would I have done?
Does nature contrive it so that even with a time machine, you can intervene to prevent your own conception, for example?
Damn time travel. So what's happened to the doc? I don't know, I quite understand, or am I just, like, not paying enough attention? Ooh.
Doc built this model of downtown Hill Valley way back in 1955. The clock tower in the courthouse even works.
It's a watch.
What the? Is that Doc's notebook in there?
Hey, that looks just like the courthouse. You gotta hand it to the old coot. He was good with his hands.
Biff, can I see that a minute?
This would look great in my fish tank. Give the old croc something new to nibble
give
on.
It.
You know, you and my folks go way back.
Yeah? So?
So how about letting me have that model courthouse for old time's sake?
I think I'll keep it.
Give it here, Biff.
Well, well.
Get the
look
that's
what
mine.
We have
give it.
Here. Looks like plans for something. What's a flux catheter?
It's none of your business. Catheter. Doc asked me to...
Brown's worm food, kid. But this looks like it might be worth something.
Give me... the courthouse.
Hey, Dad. Why is my guitar got a price tag on it?
Sorry, son. Must have been an overzealous clerk. Just pick it up. I'll iron things out with the bank.
What do you mean, iron things out with the bank? Use item. No? Ah. That's a hell of an amp. There we go.
Here's an oldie, but a goodie. One, two, three.
Hey, look, it's Chuck Butthead. Let me show you how it's done.
Now, Biff.
What a moron.
I think that's Marty's guitar.
Moron
as well.
You're right, Mr. McFly. Oh, here you go, Marty. Let's hear a few licks. Wow, that was sizzling hot. Like a melting ice cube.
What's he done with the... Oh, where's he gone?
I can't leave until I get Doc's notebook back from Biff.
Can we just go punch him in the nuts?
Hey, Biff. I only want that notebook because, well, I'm sentimental. It's like
a piece
of Doc.
Give me your lockhead.
Doc's dead. Time to get over it and move on.
It's just a notebook with Doc's scribblings. What did Doc ever accomplish?
Nothing.
And then it's worthless, right?
If it was really worthless, you wouldn't want it so bad.
That notebook wouldn't mean anything lockhead. To you. You wouldn't even understand what's in it.
You calling me ignorant?
Calling you stupid.
I just can't let you keep that notebook. It's dangerous.
What, is it set to explode or something?
Well, in a way.
I'll take my chances.
I'll pay you for it.
How much?
Not
enough.
I'll pay you for it.
How much?
Not
enough.
Never mind. Feels like that was a lifetime ago. Actually,
what
I guess it was.
What was that for?
Hope that wasn't poison gas or anything.
No, better not be. It's the last thing we want.
Hey, let me try, Marty.
Now, Biff, let Marty have his turn.
You got it, Mr. McFly.
Oh, hey, no, not Biff. Again.
Never mind.
Enough of that junk.
Now, Biff.
Sorry,
Marty.
Why don't
we just go talk to his dad and just say, Big Bully stole our model.
Hey, Dad. Who's running this sale anyway?
Oh, that'd be me, son.
You? Why?
Well, once it became apparent that the bank was going through with the sale, I volunteered to oversee it in order to make sure that Doc's stuff would be treated with a modicum of respect. Isn't that right, Biff?
You got it, Mr. McFly.
I'm telling you, this sale is a joke. Doc's only been gone for a few months, and I happen to know...
Yes, you've told us he's not dead. He's on a trip. Let's say you're right. Have you considered that this trip may not have been,
entirely
voluntary? I hate to say it, but Doc's run up some pretty sizable debts around town. Maybe
he's
just hiding from his creditors.
That notebook is Doc's legacy. I've got an obligation to protect it.
Now, hold on a minute. Didn't you just get done telling me Doc's still around?
Wait.
Off traveling
no.
somewhere?
Yeah.
Then why would Biff get it?
Then how is it your obligation to protect his legacy? You can't have it both ways, Marty. If Doc's alive, he can protect his own legacy.
You got Doc wrong. Sure, maybe he's not so good with money. That's just because his mind's always on bigger things. But he's still a straight-up guy. He'd never run away from his problems.
Well, you
but
know him better
he?
Than I do, son. But the bank is within its rights to sell off his stuff. Maybe you should try to find some things to remember him by before Biff.
I have got one. Give it to me.
About Biff, Dad, I know you're trying to help.
He talks a big game, son, but
he's
not
a bastard.
So tough. I've been dealing with him a long
you
time.
You can handle him,
believe
but he's just not giving
me
the
note
that we need.
So can I.
I guess you can. Okay, son, I'll stay out of your way. You know where
get
to find
me. Get me the notebook.
Problem? Biff?
He's got this thing, see, and I really need to get it back.
If he stole something from you...
No, it's one of Doc's notebooks. He found it first, but...
Oh, well, then I'm not sure what to tell you. I guess you'll just have to appeal
no,
to
you should
better
just turn around to him and said...
Or something.
I found it first, because technically I did.
Do you think dreams can predict the future?
Well, you know I don't go in for that mystical stuff, but I do think they can reflect how you're feeling about the future.
I'll keep looking around. Thanks, Dad. Now, something your kids are really gonna like.
Thanks for warming them up for me, butthead. Well, it's one for the monkey, two for the snow, three to get ready. Now, go, scat, go! Woo!
What the hell? So, have we just gone and got rid of all our...
Looks like a hand crank lightning rod, or maybe a lightning powered pencil sharpener.
What's it telling me to do now?
Doc must have whipped up some crazy compounds in that cauldron. Well, that smells like beef stew.
Wait, I got one.
What do we have to do?
You want to hear a number by Biff and the Bifftones? Always happy to play for my adoring fans.
Well, it's one for the monkey, two for the snow, three to get ready. Now go, Scat, go! Woo!
What do I need to do?
Quality's good, but it needs more bass. And treble. And volume.
Ah.
I don't want to mess up my picture of Dad like that.
Ah, come on.
Let's make some noise.
You want to hear a number by Biff and the Bifftones? Always happy to play for my adoring fans. Now watch me blow the lid off this joint.
Whatever you say.
Whoa!
Rock on, Biff.
Oh, shit.
Doc, where are you?
Speaking of where are yous? It's back. Just the bloody dog, isn't it?
Einstein! Where do you come from, boy? Didn't you bring Doc with you? Okay, Doc, I know I haven't seen you in a few months, but I'm pretty sure this is your shoe.
You never know what they're up to these days.
Marty?
Ah!
Marty, if you're hearing this recording, then the DeLorean's automatic retrieval feature is a resounding success.
Automatic retrieval?
In case of my failure to return to the DeLorean within an allotted time, I programmed the time machine to jump to these four-dimensional coordinates without me. As you are well aware, time travel is an inherently risky activity, and despite my elaborate precautions, there's always a possibility that I could land in trouble sometime, and that some time is now, or then, or maybe later.
He's in trouble.
Marty, you've come to my rescue in the past, or was it the future? Anyway, I'm relying on you to do it again. Please, take the DeLorean back, or forward, to whatever it is. I'm stuck in time. When you get there, I'm sure you'll figure out what to do.
That's it? Aren't you going to tell me when that is?
Just go to the date specified on the time circuit readout under the heading marked Last Time Departed. Good luck.
Right. Last Time Departed. Oh, jeez. Come on. Crap! Oh, great. How am I supposed to find him now? I can use those to enter a date into the time circuits. Once I know when to look for Doc.
Yeah, because that would be too easy.
Looks like the time circuits still work. Now I only need to know when to look for Doc. I can use those to enter a date into the time circuits. Once I know when to look for Doc.
Maybe the dog knows.
What kind of trouble is Doc in?
Where is he?
This time-traveling shoe is my only clue to finding Doc. This notebook has all of Doc's plans for the flux capacitor and the DeLorean. I'd better make sure it never falls into the wrong hands. And by wrong hands, I mostly mean Biff. I don't think so. After all the trouble I went through getting this thing, there's no way I'm letting it out of my
sight.
True,
but...
I can use those to enter a date into the time circuits. Once I know when to look for Doc.
Oh, that's great. It crashed on me. Having a good day of it today, eh? Thank God that was a continue. Oh, don't you do that.
Doc? Einstein! Where do you come from, boy? Didn't you bring Doc with you? Okay, Doc, I know I haven't seen you in a few months, but I'm pretty sure this isn't your shoe.
Automatic
retrieve.
In case of my failure to the DeLorean within an allotted time, I programmed the time machine to jump to these four-dimensional coordinates without me. As you are well aware, time travel is an inherently risky activity, and despite my elaborate precautions, there's always a possibility that I could land in trouble sometime. And that sometime is now, or then, or maybe later.
In trouble?
He's in trouble.
Marty, you've come to my rescue in the past, or was it the future? Anyway, I'm relying on you to do it again. Please, take the DeLorean back, or forward, to whatever it is. I'm stuck in time. When you get there, I'm sure you'll figure out what to do.
That's it? Aren't you going to tell me when that is?
Just go to the date specified on the time circuit readout under the heading marked Last Time Departed. Good luck.
Right. Last time departed. Oh, jeez. Come on. Crap! Oh, great. How am I supposed to find him now?
Give me the shoe.
What do you know about this shoe, Einie? Great Scott! I think he's onto something. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. How's this supposed to lead me to Doc, Einie?
Strickland. Isn't that the principal?
Step away from the door!
Ah.
Now, let me get a look at you.
Einstein, come on!
Just as I suspected. Hooligans!
Ain't no bloody hooligans.
I'm not a hooligan, ma'am. I'm a teenager.
I wasn't born yesterday, young man. Aren't you the miscreant who skateboards through the town square every morning between 8 and 8:30 in a decidedly unpunctual manner?
Yeah?
All skateboarders are hooligans. It's a fact. Look it up. State your business, child. You're making me miss Merv.
Well, see, that's the thing. I'm not sure why I'm here. Einstein here brought me, and...
Well? State your business, child! You're making me miss Merv!
Well, see, that's the thing. I'm not sure why I'm here. Einstein here brought me, and...
Well?
Can you let me in? I've got something to show you.
What is it? Let me see. A shoe? Wow, now what would I want with a... Huh? Stay there!
Oh. Whose goddamn shoe is this? There's some guy randomly holding a shoe in the street.
Sorry, Einstein.
Where's all the cats?
Well, took you long enough.
There's like,
There's a lot of stairs.
To return the shoe, I mean. I lost it. The woman from ages ago.
Minions. No.
You can
Monsters,
put
Inc.
it down next to the other
Magdowski.
One. Much better. So neat and orderly. I suppose you'll be wanting some sort of reward now.
No, I...
All I've got is tea and candy.
But...
I'm sorry I called you a hooligan. I try not to jump to conclusions, but after all, 9 out of 10 people in this city are hooligans. It's a fact. Look it up.
Time to look it up again. No, we trouble.
Have a seat, Sonny.
Him.
Hey! You kids! Put out those cigarettes!
Oh, she does have cats.
Miss Strickland?
Jack! Diane! I know what you're doing behind that tree!
Yes? Do you remember when you lost your shoe?
Shoe?
That shoe over there.
Oh, that shoe! Hi, what a nosy Nelly! No one likes a busybody, you know.
But...
Oh, fine, let me think about it. Yes, I remember. I lost it in a scuffle with a dog.
Oh, when was it?
Oh, yes. The day that speakeasy burned down.
Speakeasy?
A speakeasy? In Hill Valley?
Don't act so surprised,
the hell's a speakeasy?
Young man. Your generation doesn't hold a copyright on moral depravity, you know. Sin has been on the prowl in Hill Valley since the day it was founded.
Wow, a speakeasy. That must have been wild. Is it true they used to drink gin out of slippers like my grandma said?
Don't romanticize.
Is that how she lost her shoe?
Past, young man. Prohibition was a time when gangsters ruled the town while honest citizens quaked in their beds.
So where was it? That speakeasy that burned down, I mean.
That was ages ago. If you're looking for bootleg hooch...
No, I'm just curious, that's all. I'm a student of history.
Student of history? My Aunt Fanny!
Don't want to hear about your family.
Yeah, your generation of hooligans and slackers could give two ripe figs about history.
Miss Strickland?
Oh, video store!
Huh?
The speakeasy used to be hidden in plain sight down there in the town square. Right where that disgusting videotape rental store squats today.
So the video store building must have gone up after the speakeasy burned down.
The following year, as I recall.
Doing some stargazing?
No, I set my sights on lower things. Is that...
Chip! Chip! Get away from that hubcap before I call your father!
Tannen.
What's with all these newspapers?
This is my personal archive. I've got every issue of the Hill Valley Telegraph ever published.
Get out. Every single issue?
From 1871 to the present. If it happened in Hill Valley...
I'll come
find
in
it in my stacks.
I guess somewhere in these stacks there must be an article about the speakeasy burning down.
Naturally. I probably wrote it myself. I was quite a reporter back in the day.
Suddenly seems to lose what like that article came out.
Well,
100 years every time she
speaks. The day after the speakeasy burned down.
Don't let me keep you from your business.
You there! Don't even think about tossing that Kleenex on the ground!
Don't touch those! My newspapers are in pristine condition and meticulously organized. Not about to let some street punk get jam all over them.
Is that Vice Principal Strickland?
Mother never could keep little Gerald out of her clothes.
Gerald.
Miss Strickland, about your tea. You forgot to turn on
you!
The...
You! It's spelled with a U! You illiterate vandal!
Would you mind if I stepped out for a minute? I just remembered a video I've got to return.
Do you have to go? I get so few visitors these days.
But...
And I'd hate to have to tell my brother, your vice principal in charge of discipline, how rude you were to me. Especially with graduation coming up and all.
What are these?
My editorial trophies.
Cat Lovers Quarterly.
It's legitimate journalism. Wouldn't do that if I were you. Ms. Pretty Whiskers is very particular about who handles the food.
That tea's never gonna boil. That tea's never gonna boil.
Do we need to go speak to her again?
Man, she keeps it hot in here.
The kettle. I'll be right back with some tea. Then don't touch anything.
Juveniles collide with manure truck. Nice picture.
Classic.
Brown Mansion destroyed. 1962. No, that's not where Doc's stranded. Alright, Einstein brought me this shoe, and Miss Strickland lost the shoe on the day the speakeasy burned down. But when did the speakeasy burn down? I at least need to know the year. Hey, mind if I use your binoculars for a sec?
Go ahead, dear.
Rebuilt in February 1932. So the fire must have happened before then. But when? I need a date.
Don't look at me. I'm far too old for you. I told you not to touch those.
Marshall
Strickland. About this tea.
My grandfather, gunned down by Mad Dog Tannen over 100 years ago.
That's not how I remember it.
There's the whistle. Surely the water's boiling by now.
Jeez, they all look like they've got sticks up there.
What's that, dear?
Nothing.
Let's see. So we're getting closer.
Ground broken on site of former speakeasy. Singer vanishes. Hill Valley Expo delights crowd. Soup kitchen exposed. Here we go. Speakeasy arsonist slain. Legal procedure gave way to old-fashioned vengeance last night when a mob descended on the Hill Valley police station. The suspect in the speakeasy arson case, a drifter known as Carl Sagan, was pulled from his... Carl Sagan? It's Doc! Killed by a mob. What's the date? June 14th, 1931. Jeez, I gotta rescue him.
My newspapers!
Sorry. Sorry, Miss Strickland. Let me...
No! You've gotten my history out of
order! Oh, no, I'm sorry.
Oh, do you know how long it'll take to fix what you've done? Oh, get out! Get out! Get out!
Help! Police! I'm being attacked by hooligans!
Hooligans!
Marty! Where you been, son? And what are you doing in that getup?
It's a costume. Tonight's the big Halloween party.
Halloween party? In May? Never mind, you don't have to explain. I'm sure whatever it is you're up to, you know what you're doing, right?
Always.
I hope so.
Hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love, right? Wish my dad had understood that. You won't stay away too long.
You barely know I was gone. You ready to go, Einstein?
Let's hit it.
I've got to turn on the time circuits first.
Hey, Gillian, how you doing?
Time circuits. Flux capacitor. Fluxy.
It's not actually Michael J. Fox, which is annoying.
Okay, if Doc's gonna get killed on June 14th, 1931...
I know he does do a cameo in this.
Just show up the day before and get him out. I hope you know what you're doing, Doc.
Well, sounds a bit too young. But we've got to go back. Hear the dramatic music. Yeah, he voiced them. What? Phew, that was close. AJ Locasio. Not a clue who that is. But hey. Christopher Lloyd actually does the voice.
Einstein,
right, okay.
Where'd you go now, boy?
Classics. Was that going to be his great aunt or
the
something?
Man. Excuse me.
Oh
man.
No, it's her.
Who? Me?
You're the only man in the street, and I'm looking for a man-in-the-street reaction. Naturally, you know about the explosion that destroyed this illegal gin establishment.
Strickland!
I read about it, yeah.
What's your opinion of Carl Sagan, the stranger who single-handedly did what the law has been unable to do for 10 long years, namely, rid Hill Valley of the scourge of liquor?
The scourge, the great scourge of liquor.
There's gotta be some sort of mistake here. Carl wouldn't do something like that.
It's surprising the lengths a person will go to when it's a clear-cut matter of right and wrong. You've got an honest look about you. You do support the side of righteousness, I trust.
How'd Doc get himself into...
Doc?
Doc is his nickname. I'm good friends with Carl.
You are? Really? Oh, but I need an unbiased opinion for my story. Pretend you don't know him. How would you feel about his heroic act of destruction?
Heroic act of destruction.
You can mark me down as a supporter,
the young man said, flashing a boyish yet virile grin. Hill Valley needs more upstanding youths like yourself. Do you have a message for the vicious gangsters who still roam these streets? No doubt plotting to corrupt our citizens with another den of booze, sin, and debauchery.
Ask him where I can get the address.
Ah, I see. Because you want to blast it to smithereens, just like Carl Sagan did.
Don't want to become a terrorist.
With spirited citizens like you around, the lawless element will be on the run in no time. Mr. May I get your name?
Yeah, it's... Harry Callahan.
Thank you for sharing your candid opinions, Mr. Callahan. Edna Strickland, Hill Valley Herald.
I know. I met you back. I mean, I'm familiar with your work.
You read my column? How sweet! I know it's just an etiquette column, but I believe it'll lead to bigger and better... Oh!
Einstein, no! Down, boy!
Is this wretched creature yours? He assaulted me once before.
What's got into you?
Aggressive dogs must be kept on leash at all times. It's the law. Look it up.
Doc, I gotta find Doc.
Should go telling me to look it up again.
I guess this is where the speakeasy burned down. How'd Doc ever get mixed up in that?
Well, we know how these things work. Controls are immaculate.
Doc!
Art!
Doc!
What are you doing here?
You sent for me, Doc.
I did? When?
May 14th, 1986.
The automatic retrieval system, of course. I'd almost forgotten about that.
So what's our plan for getting you out of here?
Plan? We don't need a plan.
We don't.
Not in the slightest. The police picked me up for that speakeasy fire a couple of weeks ago, but the DA hasn't got a case. They're releasing me tomorrow morning.
So basically, I traveled 50 years into the past to deliver your car?
Sorry about that, but it's so wonderful to see you. We have a lot of catching up to do.
Yeah, you might want to hold off on that, Doc.
Great Scott! I'm going to be gunned down by gangsters on the steps of the courthouse!
Why would they do that?
Guess they didn't approve of my burning down their speakeasy.
Very funny, Doc. Maybe now we should come up with a plan?
A plan? Right. But what?
Why don't I take the DeLorean, go back in time before you were arrested, and stop you from getting caught in the first place?
That would be the logical idea.
Don't even think about it. Without my unjust incarceration, the events that sent you into the past might never happen, resulting in a paradox of continuum-shattering proportions.
Jeez, we've been back together for 5 minutes, Doc, and you're already talking about the end of the universe. I've missed that.
Don't be ridiculous, Marty. I was only referring to the end of the universe as we know it.
I suppose I could just get some dynamite and break you out of jail.
No, that's far too dangerous. Not just to me, but to random innocent people in the past. The repercussions could be... That's it!
What's it?
My rocket-powered drill.
You what?
You have a rocket-powered drill?
Not yet. I haven't built it yet.
You've lost me, Doc.
Listen, a few months ago, my 17-year-old self sent in a patent application for a rocket-powered drill. I abandoned the project after I never heard back from the patent office, but the prototype should be nearly complete.
Great, I'll just run back to your lab and...
No, I said nearly complete. You need me to help you finish it.
How the hell am I supposed to sneak a half-finished rocket-powered drill into your cell?
Not me. 1931 me.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to convince your 1931 self to build a rocket-powered drill to break you out of jail?
Precisely.
That's making my head hurt.
I'm supposed to convince your younger self to finish the rocket drill. Just tell him I need to break his older self out of jail?
Absolutely not. Whatever you do, you can't tell my younger self anything about time travel. I won't come up with the inspiration for the flux capacitor for another 24 years.
Then what am I supposed to...
Just be your charming self. From what I remember, I'm a pretty easygoing kid, so enlisting me in a scientific adventure should be a piece of cake.
Okay, let's say I go along with this crazy idea. Where can I find you? I mean, the other you.
How should I know? It was over 50 years ago. Why don't you go over to the soup kitchen next door and give my house a call? They'll know where to find me.
Soup kitchen. Got it.
Just stay away from the soup. It'll cause irreparable damage to your digestive system.
Lovely stuff.
I guess I better get started. Don't worry, Doc. I'll get you out of here in no time.
I'm not worried. Once you and my younger self put your heads together, you'll be unstoppable.
Rocket-powered drill. Oh, I thought it was loading. Yeah, that's the thing. It's actually Christopher Lloyd. Is it actually playing him? Because Michael J. The guy playing Marty McFly doesn't sound great.
McFly?
Oh, awesome.
Biff?
I never read
Kid.
The books.
Grandpa?
The movies were really good.
That's Mr. Cannon to you, Artie. What are you doing out here?
Classic.
Well, I was getting kind of hungry, so I figured I'd come down here for some
books.
Free soup.
Just thought I'd come down for some soup. Think, McFly. The DA's
Wish
throwing around subpoenas
more.
Like
Definitely
Babe Ruth.
I
more.
Don't think Ruth's a pitcher anymore.
Shut it. If one of those subpoenas
and
landed
much
in the hands of my number
watch,
cruncher,
we'll
I'd be in
a
whole
a
lot of trouble. I could even get sent up the river. You wouldn't want that, would you? Would you?
No, of course not, kid.
All right. That's better. What are you looking at, punk? Keep your eyes on the soup, kid. Well,
what?
What are you
yeah,
still doing
Yeah, they do that
here.
Yeah, like, whenever
Sorry,
it comes around
kid,
to Christmas
I'll
or whatever, they always show
the
Back to Future movies.
You do that.
So
and
good.
And McFly.
But
yes?
That hat's too flashy. You
was
better
I saw,
let me hold on.
Over Christmas, I saw the third one. Most of it,
now
anyway.
Scram!
You got it,
Up
boss.
To the bit where they shoot him, where he's
don't come out
where
until
he has
I
the
give
face
you the
up
all
with
clear.
Mad Dog.
I swear,
that was awesome.
If even one of you mooks could add 2 + 2 without your fingers, I'd dump that wimp into the lake. Hey, anyway, I'm off to make myself irresistible. Don't let anyone burn down the shop while I'm gone.
I just need to use your phone. Please let me use your phone.
Okay. Hey, never mind.
Oh, there's the phone. We haven't got any money, have we? What a surprise.
Like a thorn bush in a drunkard's hand is a proverb in the mouth of a fool. Heavy.
Ring, 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 ring.
Brown residence.
Brown.
Hi. Do you know where I could find Emmett Brown?
Young Master Brown is currently tending to his clerking duties at the courthouse. Who may I say is calling?
The courthouse? Doc never told me he worked at the courthouse.
Huh. Interesting fact. Revelations 21:6. I have no idea what that is.
Nah.
What was there, What was the last book I read? I think I tried to read The Lord of the Rings. I can never say the name of it. It's not Lord of the Rings. It's... What do you mean I forgot? What did I forget? 21:6. Uh-oh.
Don't touch those. These are very sensitive legal documents. Nobody is supposed to handle them but sworn officers of the court. Judge Brown says so.
Judge Brown?
Judge Brown? Doc. Nice to meet you. I'm, Harry Callahan.
Emmett Brown. But I am a law clerk, not a doctor. Now please get out of my way. I have important business to transact.
Quick, chase him! Alpha and Omega. I tell you what, if I was a religious person, I'd probably know that.
Listen, Emmett, you don't know me, but I'm your friend.
I'm not big on friends. They get in the way of work.
Listen, I understand you're working on a new invention in your lab.
Invention?
Ugh.
You must have me mixed up with somebody else. I'm in law. I have absolutely no interest in science.
You liar. It's a big nose liar.
No solicitors!
I better not. Those lawyers sound kind of nasty. Come on, wait up a minute.
You again? Can't you see I'm busy?
Oh, God's sake.
Okay, so you don't want your old man to know. That's fine. Listen, we all keep secrets.
How am I totally, like, oblivious to things like that?
I am not.
You see how much
scientist.
I don't pay attention to some of that sort of stuff. And when we started Fallout 3,
what does
I just skipped
equal?
It.
I have absolutely no idea. See? I don't know where you got your information from about me, mister, but you're wrong, wrong, wrong.
How are you getting on with your Fallout 3 playthrough? Have you sussed it out yet?
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Callahan.
See, I'm sort of in the science business myself. That's why I sought you out.
Not that I care in the least, because science is the furthest thing from my own area of interest, which is law, but I don't believe
you. Need to go back to Fallout 4 at some point as well. I haven't played that in ages.
So tell me something, Mr. Scientist, from your vast storehouse of scientific knowledge.
The leg bone's connected to the thigh bone?
Amazing.
Come on, Doc. Emmett, drop the Legal Eagle Act. I got something more important for you to do.
Mr. Callahan, I'll have you know that the law is the very mortar
that holds society together. Oh, you're heading into
the
DLC land.
We in the legal profession are like brick masons building the edifice of the future.
Yeah, I...
Your dad tell you that?
Every morning.
So, Emmett, what time are you through with work?
Depends. On weeknights, Pop sometimes keeps me in the office till 9.
9 at night? But today's Saturday.
Right. So I probably won't get off before 10.
How about you knock off work early and I'll buy you a beer, or soda. What do you say?
Don't try to tempt me from my duty with sugary beverages. Keeping
yeah,
the
I've
wheels of justice turning. That's my one passion in life. Besides, if I left before
progress
8, my
lots
pop
of that
would
stuff.
Kill me.
Sounds like you're a little scared of your father.
And how bad
of my
is this?
Father? Hop is the most learned,
the
just,
is still pending.
Judge that Hill Valley has ever seen. The only people scared of Judge Brown are people with a dark secret to hide. And I don't have a dark
secret. After doing
to
some
hide.
Research, some are most like where they're mostly like
what's this important business you have to?
Ones that
it's
have
a legal matter,
more.
Very complicated, very abstruse. I need to obtain 5 sets of initials on every copy of this writ of was indemnification before Pop, I mean, before Judge Brown can even think of granting a waiver.
Sometimes
to
it can take like a couple
part.
Of weeks because it takes so
no
so many emotes get submitted a day.
That's
and
how important it
if
is.
If it was just like one of a face, it would be a bit different, but it's not.
Come on, you could trust me, Doc. Emmett, it's your future I'm looking out for, in more ways than one.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you and science.
Oh, that word again! If you insinuate I'm a scientist once more, I'll sue you for defamation of character!
Now if H stands for the one-dimensional harmonic oscillator.
Come on.
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a
into
federal
the
crime, Mr. Callahan.
Into downtown pit.
Damn it, about your...
Say it.
God, I think I only ever played the DLC once, so I wouldn't know. I just remember, isn't the pit in the north? The north of the map.
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Callahan.
Sounds like you're a little scared of your father.
Scared of my father? Pop is the most learned, just, incorruptible judge that Hill Valley has ever seen. The only people scared of Judge Brown are people with a dark secret to hide. And I don't have a dark secret
yeah,
to hide.
Yeah, you do. You're a scientist.
Emmett, about your...
Don't say it.
Okay.
...for the one-dimensional harmonic oscillator, or do we take H to stand for the Hermitian line operator? But in that case, H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A...
The dog's gonna have to help me. Ooh, ooh.
Hey,
I know what I do. Book. I'm so annoyed that we got glitched out of that game. Really wound me up. Though, I know I was talking about it yesterday during stream, but I need to set up my 360 and see if I can get that to work. We'll get there.
Doc's notebook doesn't belong to him. Okay, actually, it does belong to him, but not yet. In any event, it's probably a really bad idea
no.
to give him a book full of all the things he hasn't invented yet.
Oh, by the way, I have, in case you're on it, started a new Twitter account. Links in the bottom of the channel, but I finally decided to do that because it's just easier to let people know when I am streaming. The DLC is really good, actually. What was the one I didn't like? It was the harbour one, I think. It won't give you time to DLC. Ah. Let's try that. Yeah, I'll try and refresh it, or just I'll have to go for a restart. What's Fallout 4?
Just give me a chance.
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Callahan.
And about your...
Don't say it.
What does he want me to do?
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Callahan.
No, it's not the harbor.
Sounds like you're a little scared of your father.
Point lookout, I think it is. I think that's the one that was really not that good.
Pop is the most learned, just, incorruptible judge that Hill Valley has ever seen. The only people scared of Judge Brown are people with a dark secret to hide. And I don't have a dark secret to hide.
Yeah, man. About your...
Don't say it.
The spaceship one's quite good.
Fast times acceleration, of course. That's...
Ugh. What am I supposed to do? Oh, there we go.
Think, Emmett, think. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. Now, if H stands for one. Think, Emmett, think. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A.
Yeah, I thought it was about time. I'll just get Twitter, get it done, because I still do the updates on there, but it just doesn't seem to be, don't know, it just doesn't seem to be like a...
Think, Emmett, think. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A.
Doc will want to hear this.
Which Doc? Yeah, so I'll still be like updating both of them, but I know Twitter seems like a good idea to get started.
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Callahan.
Okay, so it's not this one.
Damn it. About
Don't
your...
say it.
So we need to go speak to the doc that's in prison. Prison doc. Yeah, it's more just like, it seems to be like more convenient for people because I don't know who looks at my page, who looks at the updates, who or whatever, just, you know, seemed like a good idea. For the time being, anyway.
So, Doc, does this ring a bell?
Oh, think, Emmett, think. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A.
Good grief! Is that me? I sound so...
young?
I was gonna say intense. I forgot how wound up I used to get.
Yeah, but what are you muttering about?
Look at him in the background.
Easy. It's Ivanov's conundrum. Just tell my younger self that H equals a Hamiltonian operator.
Won't giving him the answer mess up the time stream?
Only if it turns out that reality is actually nothing more than a holographic illusion created by the interplay of subatomic particles on a vast two-dimensional membrane.
So...
it'll be fine.
Well, it's getting him to actually listen to the tape recorder, but that's what I was like. I'll go talk to, let's call him Present Doc, and then Past Doc. Oh, I'm going to get confused. These Telltale games have got awful controls.
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Callahan.
Maybe H equals the Hamiltonian operator.
What did you just say?
This is how we learn it.
Maybe H equals the Hamiltonian operator.
Video games.
Yeah.
Great Scott! If H is the Hamiltonian, then H to the A multiplied by the inverse of H can only be the same as the expectation value for A. That's it! That's the solution to Ivanov's conundrum, the problem I've been wrestling with in my head all week!
I'm sure you would have figured it out by yourself in a day or two. The way you figured out how to build that rocket-powered drill.
Where did you learn so much about science?
Well, it's like this.
You know about my rocket-powered drill? Then there can only be one explanation.
What?
You're from the patent office! I confess I didn't quite know what to expect when I sent the paperwork, but I never expected this. Welcome! I'm at your service. What can I do for you?
Can I see your rocket-powered drill?
Of course, of course. Naturally, it's just a scale model, but it's nearly operational. I can show it to you, say, first thing in the morning.
Nah, that's no good. I need to see a full-size model. That's fully operational. Tonight. Otherwise, we'll have to award the patent to a competing inventor, Dr. McCoy.
It can't be done! I mean, it might be possible to construct a full-size working model in that time frame, but I haven't got the main ingredient for the fuel.
I'll get it for you. What is it?
190-proof grain alcohol. And you know how difficult it is to get a hold of alcohol these days.
Especially now that someone's blown up the speakeasy.
And besides, there's no way I can get off work until I've delivered the subpoena. It's part of the investigation into the business affairs of Kid Tannen. Is it vitally important you see that rocket-powered drill today?
Yes. Is it vitally important you deliver that subpoena today?
Yes!
Listen, I'll help you deliver it, and I'll see to it you get the alcohol you need. If it'll help you get that drill finished by tonight. Deal?
Deal. Here's the subpoena.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
Arthur McFly? I've got a subpoena my grandpa.
Shh! It's Kid Tannen!
Hey, I just saw him at the soup kitchen, yelling at Arthur McFly.
I'm not surprised. Arthur does the books for his business.
What kind of business?
That's what the DA is trying to find out.
Let's go talk to him.
No!
Why not? Kid Tannen can tell us where Arthur's hiding.
Oh, quite dramatic,
well,
really, isn't it?
Fitted for a Chicago overcoat.
Well, at least we're learning new things.
I don't want to record them right now.
You don't
now.
Need to record her. You just need to listen.
Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Callahan. Try not to draw any undue attention my way. I'm on the trail of a hot new scoop, as we in the newspaper business say.
What's the scoop?
I've heard rumors that something shady is going on at the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen. It's under new management, you know. And, oh, we mustn't jump
you
to
never
any
know.
Conclusions. Not till the facts are in. I hope to heaven it is just a rumor. That soup kitchen is the front line in the good fight. If it goes bad, what will happen to the Stay Sober Society? Not to mention all the charitable institutions that depend
on me
for soup deliveries.
It's all very suspicious.
Did you finish the story you interviewed me for? About Carl Sagan?
Yes, but those pig-headed editors at the paper rejected it. They said my story was slanted, and that I was glorifying a suspected arsonist. As if their stories aren't always glorifying the criminal vermin that run this town. This whole thing makes me so mad I could spit! Though of course I never would. There's an ordinance against it, and it's
filthy
so untidy.
You make hot soup deliveries?
It's one of my many small contributions to the good cause. Healthy bodies, healthy souls, or so one hopes. I pick up barrels of hot soup at the kitchen, and
stuck
I deliver them hither
find
and thither.
The good fight.
Hill Valley Orphanage, the St. Francis Xavier Ranch for Unwanted Children, Foggy Mountain Home for the Incurably Insane, Shady Acres Rest Home. Oh, I can barely keep track of them all. It's a very big job.
Hey, I can help you deliver soup, but I donate a lot of time to charities.
Oh? Which ones?
The, Mario Brothers.
Ah, yes. The Italians do so many good works.
If you'll just fix it so I can pick up the barrels of soup.
Now hold your horses, let's not get overeager. I drive the soup cycle in this town, and I'm not about to turn it over to an upstart. But if you're well connected with the local charitable institutions...
Yeah?
You can let me know when they're running low on soup.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, I do know a local charity that's running low on soup.
Oh, who?
The Farm for Unwanted Children.
The Farm for Unwanted Children.
Perhaps their parents don't want them because they eat too much.
Stuck up, bitch. Ah, let's push her in the road.
All right, Edna. Just think of all those poor unfortunates and hold your nose.
Mr. Donnelly!
Yeah, that's how they carry soup, in a barrel. Okay, so that's a whole elaborate scene that we've, I don't quite understand what exactly we've done.
What the hell, Matches? You got kiwi all over kiwi? My socks!
Sorry,
kiwi?
Boss.
Get out of
1930s,
here.
1930s, they all had kiwis.
How about you? Huh? I'm sitting at a shoe shine booth. You walk up. Either you're here to shine my shoes, or you got a death wish. Which is it?
Yeah, shine the shoes.
I'm looking for a guy named Arthur McFly. He's my, sort of a relative.
Honestly, I don't know.
He's my employee.
I don't think it is.
He's very busy today.
Since you're Arthur's boss, you know where he is, right?
He's at the, office.
Where's the office?
I forget.
So when do you think Arthur will be leaving the office?
When I tell him he can leave the office.
Yeah, I don't think this is
Mr. Spy.
Isn't that Arthur McFly's hat you're holding?
It was McFly's hat. Now, it's my peanut bowl.
Could I buy Arthur's hat off you?
Could you keep your mind on your work, huh? Shoeshine boy? I'm hanging on to my peanut bowl.
Can I have some peanuts?
Why not? I'm a magnanimous kind of guy. Go ahead, knock yourself out. Hey, kid!
Yeah?
What the hell is that?
Yoink.
Hey!
Why are we stealing his hat?
What'd you do?
I don't even know why we're stealing his hat.
Give me that hat, you lousy crook! Emmett!
Run. What the hell's going
on?
I know, right? It's like, wait. We obviously need it for something.
Nobody
but...
makes a monkey out of Kid Tannen. Hey!
Come on, monkey boy.
Fix me up!
Where do you learn how to move like that?
Sandlot football. They used to call me the Streak.
Get out!
So now we're going around stealing stuff. So the hint says that earlier we used an object to find its owner. We're looking for my grandfather. And why did we just steal a hat? Now we know. And there's the dog.
Hey, honey. Come here for a sec, boy. Hey, boy, can you find the guy who belongs to this hat?
Come on, boy.
Where's he going?
Only one way to find out.
I like that. That looks familiar.
Huh. Deja vu.
McFly?
Yeah? Who is it?
It's McFly!
Shh, I know!
Arthur, can you come down a minute?
Do I know you?
We've got something for you.
It's a
subscription to the Accountant Weekly. He won't come out if he knows why we're really here.
No, right.
Dumb bastard.
I'm not interested. And besides, the boss won't let me leave the room. Sorry. Some other time.
No. We're gonna keep buzzing.
What now?
I'll give it back to him after I give him the subpoena.
Right, there we go.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm throwing the subpoena.
You can't do that. You have to hand it to him.
Okay, so we can't just do that.
It's me again. Please come down.
Why?
We've got some important information for you, but we can't yell it. It's private.
Then put it in a postcard and send it. I'm stuck up here till the boss tells me I can leave.
Bitch.
Sorry. Some other time.
Sorry. No. You ain't getting away with that.
What now?
Answer the goddamn door.
It's me again. Please come down.
Why?
I'm your grand... mother's great nephew.
You mean my second cousin?
Yeah.
Glad to know you, but I can't leave this building till the boss says so. He's given strict orders. Sorry. Some other time.
Alright, one more try, and then we're gonna have to figure out what's going on.
What now?
Because I don't know.
It's me again. Please come down.
Why?
We represent the law.
You don't want to go against the law, do you?
No, but I don't want to go against Kid Tannen either. And he ordered me to stay put till he gives the word. Sorry. Some other time.
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Need any help?
Never mind.
I don't...
Now.
I'll try this. If it doesn't work, we'll start using the hints.
Arthur's already a little freaked out. I think showing him a picture of his yet-to-be-born son could turn him into a vegetable.
Could do. Be funny, though.
Doc's notebook doesn't belong to them.
All right. I need to get something from the town center. What do I need to get? Soup! So we go get soup. Is it?
Ugh.
Maybe it's soup, maybe it's not soup, I don't know.
Hey, cue ball.
What?
The truck just arrived with a fresh shipment of, soup.
Soup? Soup?
Well, this is the regular soup, and this is the special soup.
Right. Special.
Hey, what are you
making
doing?
Soup?
I'm spicing up the soup. It's my secret recipe.
Listen, this ain't the Savoy, and we ain't here to feed these bozos no fancy soup. The boss has got a business to rebuild, so knock off the goofing and mind your post.
All right, just try the soup.
Cabbage soup. Ugh.
Well?
I can see why you want to keep this a secret.
Excuse me.
You talking to me?
Can I have a bowl of soup?
We're a soup kitchen. What do you think?
Gunpowder or drugs? It would be one or the other, but I think you're right, actually. It's more likely gunpowder.
What kind of soup is this? It tastes like...
Scrolle ribollita?
I was gonna say week-old cabbage.
Everyone's a critic. Look, all I got to work with is this two-bit soup in a barrel and spice rack that hadn't been restocked since the Coolidge administration. What do you think I should do to perk this slop up?
Let's see. Have you tried... salt?
Salt? What, do you think it's too bland? Too mild? I didn't put too much pepper in it, did I?
Now we just can tell him how to...
more salt.
No accounting for taste these days.
Tell him how to make his soup.
Kitchen's for management only, Rummy.
Whoa!
Okay.
I better not talk to him. I don't want to mess up his timeline.
What about Emmett? Okay, so...
What is it, kid?
Why is the soup in a barrel?
Because it's hard to ladle off the floor.
Okay, I've got some more ideas about your soup.
Do tell.
Let's see. Have you tried... paprika?
Paprika?
I just think it could use a little... color.
Color? Hmm.
So what do we need to do?
Those who once ate delicacies are destitute in the street. Cheery. There's no way I'm gonna keep that door open without some help. I better not talk to him. I don't want to mess up his timeline.
Bet Usain Bolt for all options. I don't quite understand.
For we were born only yesterday and know nothing, and our days on Earth are but a shadow. Actually, I won't be born for about 40 years.
Open the kitchen door.
There's no way I'm gonna keep that door open without some help.
Oh, yeah, that's it. It's like a...
Looks like these pipes go into the basement.
Uh-oh.
Ah, Miss Strickland. Come for some more soup?
Come now, Mr. Donnelly. You know I wouldn't set one foot in this mockery of all that is good and decent if the poor of Hill Valley weren't so dependent on Mr. Tennant's overblown show of generosity.
Take that stick out of her ass.
Just give me the soup before I gag on the hypocrisy.
I'll tell the boss you said hello.
I'll just bet you will.
Can we go around the back? No. God damn.
Nice bike. Huffy?
Huffy? I'm not huffy. I'm passionate. Passionate about justice, safety, law, and order.
Never mind. Hey, Mr. Strickland.
All right, mate. Well, it's nice to catch up with you. You have a good one, and I'll catch up with you soon.
Try not to draw attention my way. I'm on the trail of a hot new scoop, as we in the newspaper business say.
What's the Stay Sober Society?
You haven't heard of the SSS? They do the most marvelous work, taking hopeless drunken bums and turning them into former hopeless drunken bums. I'm one of the founding members. And not to say that I was ever, well, you know. Anyway, we've always met in the cellar of the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen, but for some reason the new managers don't want us down there, so we're stuck. We've got nowhere to meet.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
I know an apartment that's empty, but you'd have to break in.
The Stay Sober Society does not countenance breaking and entering.
Okay.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
You can meet in the park.
No, that's no good. Too many of the members sleep in the park.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
The Brown residence.
You mean Judge Brown's place?
Yeah, I happen to be good friends with his son Emmett, and he's told me the judge would love to lend his place out for, you know, good causes like yours.
Really?
Yep.
Why, that's the most that's generous, public-spirited offer I've received
on,
in a
are we
month
get
of Sundays.
To deliver
Please
the alcohol.
Tell your friend Emmett we accept. The meeting isn't due to start for a little while, so that'll give our people some time to set up.
You asked me to tell you if one of the local charities is running low on soup.
Does somebody need a visit from my soup cycle?
The Stay Sober Society.
Bless you for thinking of them. But that meeting isn't scheduled to start for a little while. And we wouldn't want them eating cold
really?
Soup.
I'm sorry about the way Einstein lit into you back there. I don't know what got into him.
Well, I hope you've learned to keep him under control.
Yeah, I found someone to keep him distracted.
Very good. Now let's see if you know your multiplication tables.
You asked me to tell you if one of the local charities is running low on soup.
Does somebody need a visit from my soup cycle?
The insane asylum.
Whose inmates are crazy for soup?
Just crazy for soup. So how do I stop her? You set up the delivery. How many woof X woof? Woof woof. Arf. Arf but arf woof bark. Crack me up.
What is it, kid?
So this place used to be a soup kitchen.
What do you mean, used to be? Despite recent changes in ownership, this joint is still available for the purposes of distributing food to the needy and the not-so-well-to-do. And no other purposes whatsoever.
Yeah, right.
Mind if I look around a bit?
No.
Right, I'm gonna have to go with these hints. What's he doing? Oh. That's a new one. Well, that's the thing. I was trying that, and it wouldn't let me actually speak to Brown. Oh, now we can speak to him.
Huddle up, Emmett.
Huddle?
Just listen up for a second. Emmett, I can't get into the door over there. Those tables are jamming it shut.
The door? So your plan is to just waltz in there and take a barrel of alcohol?
No, of course not. That would be stupid, right?
I'll say.
Still, I'd like to get that door open. I can't do anything from out here.
Well, it's a simple matter of physics. A lever, some sort of stop. Let me see what I can come up with.
Yeah, the old switcheroo into the ground trick.
What is it, kid?
I still think the soup needs more flavor.
Oh, at least it's not making me pick. Right, Emmett. Do your thing.
There's no way I'm gonna keep that door open without some help.
What?
Eureka!
Oh, there we go, he's figured it out. Yeah, it was a bit of a weird one. That patience.
Pretty neat, Doc. Nope. I'm still not getting through here. But at least those tables are propped up now.
Do we get him to steal it for us? It's definitely a confusing one.
What is it, kid?
I still think the soup needs more flavor. hope Doc Jr.'s thingamabob holds out. Pretty neat, Doc. Nope. I'm still not getting through here. But at least those tables are propped up now.
This is really confusing. Am I the only one that's like losing their mind over this?
Pretty neat, Doc. Nope. I'm still not getting through here. But at least those tables are propped up now. I better not talk to him. I don't want to mess up his timeline. I still think the soup needs more flavor.
What?
The kitchen's for management only, Rummy.
Whoa!
All right, see you then, mate. Have a good one.
Emmett.
Yes?
Oh, that's interesting.
Just a little mechanical ingenuity. In the end, the door is open.
Yeah, good job. Any ideas about how to get the hooch?
Somebody's got to know how to do this.
Alcohol, Emmett.
One might come to the conclusion that the hooch is being hidden in some of those barrels.
You're probably right, but which ones?
Now, if I could get my hands on some of those barrels, I could weigh them and compare their specific gravity.
Specific gravity? Come on, Emmett. Kids' goons aren't going to let us do an experiment on their barrels.
No, I suppose you're right. We'll just have to ask the guy behind the counter.
Tell me.
What? Ask him if any of his barrels are filled with illegal moonshine? Get real.
Something
here.
A bit different than just standing there trying to fit through a door that doesn't open the whole way. That'd be nice.
Subtlety. Right. We'll score that hooch somehow.
I'll keep cogitating.
Yes, you keep cogitating.
What is it, kid?
So this place used to be a soup kitchen.
What do you mean, used to be? Despite recent changes in ownership, this joint is still available for the purposes of distributing food to the needy and the not-so-well-to-do. And no other purposes whatsoever.
Right. I hope Doc Jr.'s thingamabob holds out.
What about these tables, though? This is really starting to baffle me. What was that? Well, that's all well and good, but how do we get in there?
hope Doc Jr.'s thingamabob holds out. Emmett.
Yes?
Obviously, this kitchen isn't a speakeasy.
And then the tables are there, but how do we get them moved?
This must be some sort of front meant to cleverly and legally obfuscate the existence of a hidden establishment of ill repute. Perhaps in the basement.
Right. That might explain the elevator. We'll score that hooch somehow.
I'll keep cogitating.
What about those barrels?
What about them?
What kind of soup is that?
It's not soup. It's special soup.
What's special about it?
It's made for grown-ups, kid.
A soup for grown-ups?
That's right, kid. Be nosy. See where it gets you.
Are those all cabbage soup?
Last time I checked.
Don't you have any other kinds of soup?
No.
No.
What is it, kid?
What's a tough guy like Kid Tannen doing running a soup kitchen?
Mr. Tannen purchased the soup kitchen from the Sisters of Mercy in an effort to repair his reputation as a respectable community figure after his fine name was besmirched by the malignant and malicious the actions of the misguided vandals that done burned down his place of business.
Is speakeasy.
I cannot confirm nor deny any claims of so-called illegal bootlegging at the...
Yeah? Spit it out.
Just eat your damn soup, pipsqueak.
I still think the soup needs more flavor. Eli thought she was drunk and said to her, "How long will you keep on getting drunk? Get rid of your wine." Eli should mind his own business. Pretty neat, Doc. Nope. I'm still not getting through here.
All right, that's it.
But at least those tables are propped up now.
Well, That was an awkward pain in the ass.
What is it, kid?
I still think the soup needs more flavor.
Nice.
More soup?
Please. And tell Kid that soup or no soup, he's not fooling anyone.
He just checked her out.
Edna picked up the barrel of hooch. Now all we have to do is to get it from her somehow.
Can get it delivered.
Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Callahan. I'm afraid I haven't much time. The meeting of the Stay Sober Society is due to begin very soon.
You asked me to tell you if one of the local charities is running low on soup.
Does somebody need a visit for my soup cycle?
The Stay Sober Society.
That's right. They'll soon be gathering at the Brown Estate, and we haven't provided refreshments. I can't get over the generosity of your friend Emmett volunteering his father's house for our meeting.
Huh? Wait there!
Harry! What in the name of Thomas Alva Edison do you think you're doing?
Don't you get it? You need alcohol to run your drill, right? Those bootleggers at the soup kitchen won't let us get our hands on any of their hooch. But we can get Miss Strickland to pick it up for us and deliver it right to your door.
No, out of the question.
Why?
I can't just let strangers invade my parents' house. What do we know about these people?
They're sober. It says so right in the name.
Well, okay, but a pop needs his peace and quiet at the end of the day. This meeting is sure to be too noisy for him.
They'll be quiet. You'll be quiet, right?
Oh, yes! I play my tambourine very softly.
You hear that?
Tambourine?
Yes, but...
But what?
But it's still impossible.
But I promised Miss Strickland. It means so much to her.
The answer is still no.
But think of the Stay Sober Society. What'll happen to them?
They can all fall off the wagon for all I care.
Okay, forget the whole thing. We don't have to test your rocket-powered drill tonight.
We don't?
No, I'll take the train back to Washington and I'll tell the folks at the office to give the patent to Dr. McCoy.
Wait!
Yeah, that'll do it.
You will instruct the members of the society to wipe their feet before they come inside.
Then you are Emmett Brown. I thought as much. You have such a righteous face.
Crazy old bat.
Edna Strickland. I don't know how to thank you for your generosity.
Oh, pleased to meet you.
The feeling is mutual.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
You worry too much, Emmett. Now all we gotta do is serve that subpoena, and we're off to build your rocket drill.
And get my patent.
Oh, we haven't done the subpoena.
Your, patent.
Thank you.
Well, well, look who's back. They say rats always return to the scene of the sinking ship. Get him, Matches.
What? What's going on?
Come down from there, you son of a bitch! Right now! That's an order! What do you think you're doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now! Don't make me angry, Schmucko! Get down here and face the music!
Einstein! Help!
Lay off! Get away from me, you crazy mutt!
Go away, dog! We're busy here! Go on, scram! Hey! Where'd he go?
Did him.
You let him get away, idiot!
Alright, let's go get him.
I don't think so.
What now?
What do you think you're doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now!
It's Kid! Right away, boss! Where's Kid?
I don't want to record them right now. Arthur McFly?
Yeah?
Got something for you.
Thanks. A subpoena?
Ordering you to appear in court and provide evidence in the investigation into...
Kid Tannen? Take it back!
You can't get rid of it, Mr. McFly. Once you've been served, it's your duty to report to the court at the earliest possible time. Failure to do so could lead to a warrant for your arrest.
Arrest? But Kid'll kill me. Stupid Artie. Holy cats, what am I gonna do?
I suggest you avail yourself to the protection of the court.
Oh gosh.
Well...
Well, we've served the subpoena and gotten a barrel of booze delivered to your house. Looks like we're off to your lab to build your rocket drill. You do have a lab, right?
What kind of future patent holder would I be without a lab? Come on!
Doc! I'm off to get the rocket drill.
Good!
Come on, let's go! Time waits for no man.
Are you sure this is gonna work, Emmett?
It's a hell of a thing.
Don't let the ramshackle nature of my laboratory fool you. If all goes according to plan, we'll soon be in possession of the most powerful rocket fuel known to man.
That's great. How?
Well, it's very simple. This crankshaft induces a powerful direct current into the electrolysis chamber, producing hydrogen, which must be periodically released into the primary distillation barrel. While tending to the hydrogen, we'll also need to regularly sprinkle these shredded protein flakes into this aquarium of tuber bacteria to generate the necessary nitrogen to catalyze the reaction.
cool.
Oh, hot! Extremely hot! The temperature of the reaction must be kept at a steady temperature of 623 degrees Kelvin by carefully pumping these bellows! Any questions?
Emmett? Why is there a brace of drunkards gathering on our lawn?
Sweet fancy Moses, it's my father!
So?
So, he doesn't know I'm engaging in acts of scientific exploration in here. He thinks this is where I go to pour through my law books.
Oh.
You tend to the reaction. I'll try to get rid of him.
Tend to the... what? Can't we just start over after he's gone?
It's too late. The reaction's already started. Don't worry. I'll try to help you out where I can.
But...
Emmett?
Coming, Father! Father!
Don't you father me, child.
This isn't food for thought, Pop. It's gruel. Listen to the words I'm emphasizing.
Don't you turn your back on me.
Maybe I should just get struck by lightning. Would that make you happy? What did you do?
Emmett, who are you talking to in there?
No one, Father.
What?
Just pay attention to what I say.
Emmett, I'm not through with you yet.
I thought you were a scientist!
Emmett!
Pressuring me to be something I'm not! Don't touch anything until I tell you to!
Emmett!
Maybe your burning passion, Father, but it is not mine.
Okay, I get it.
Why won't you release me from your unattainable expectation? Why don't you go feed the ducks, Father?
That's a pretty bad way to speak to him.
Excellent. Now twist the valve there. Great. We're about a quarter of the way home.
Emmett, get back here!
Oops. This may come as a shock to you, Pop, but not everyone wants to be a lawyer. Can't you see this is eating me up inside? My Galileo's rotations. Do you ever listen to yourself? Flame inside me that cannot be quelled by your legalistic gobbledygook, Father. Stop being such a crank! Halfway there!
Emmett!
Keep up the good work! Stop getting so hot under the collar, Pop. Why don't you ever listen to me? I don't know what's eating you, Father, but I wish you would go on a diet. Don't you have a release valve on your mouth somewhere? You know who invented fire, Pop? I don't know either, but you can be damn sure it wasn't a lawyer.
You keep bellowing like that.
Lawyers are nothing but overblown bags of gas.
Trying to spin this argument around to my failings.
Shut
don't get to control my life just because you fed and clothed me for 17 years.
Almost there.
Whew.
Coming, Father! Hotter you get, the more I know I'm right. Is it my fault if I don't get a spark out of laws and statutes? Lawyers are nothing but a bunch of hot air. There, I said it.
No.
Listen to the words I'm emphasizing.
Image!
Galileo's rotations. Do you ever listen to yourself? No idea what kind of pressure I'm under. Why are you always bellowing at me? Lawyers are nothing but overblown bags of gas. You don't like my performance at the courthouse, then fire me. If it weren't for scientists, men like you would still be divining the future with sheep's bladders and goat gizzards. Being such a crank! How many times do I have to prove myself to you before I can shake your overbearing criticisms? You call a room full of lawyers trapped in a burning building a good start? Why should I honor your wishes? You treat me like common bacteria. Maybe I should just get struck by lightning. Would that make you happy?
I'm afraid we'll have to take this up later, Pop. My soup's about to boil over.
What? This isn't over, young man.
Whew.
Are you okay? You and your dad sounded...
It was an argument we should have had a long time ago. We... No!
What?
Eureka!
Great Scott!
Now all we gotta do is fuel up the old rocket power drill and you and I can...
I can take it and go.
But don't you want to test it first?
No time. The last train for DC leaves in just a few minutes.
All right. You've gotta get this baby to the U.S. Patent Office.
Exactly.
So tell me, Harry, when can I expect to hear back from the Patent Office?
Oh, in about, I'd say... I can't.
Huh?
Emmett, I'm not from the patent office.
I don't understand.
I lied to you, but I didn't want to. It was the only way I can get you to trust me. See, there's somebody who's in big trouble. Someone very important to me, to both of us. I can't tell you who, but I need to save him tonight, and I need your invention to do it. I'll get it back to you, I promise. And, Emmett, you're gonna be a great inventor.
That was probably the worst thing you could have done.
Wait! Keep the throttle at about 8.
Okay, Doc, I got the drill. Now let's get you out of here. Come on, start. Supposed to be. Doc!
They're moving him to another facility for safekeeping. Oh, I better go get a quote from the police chief.
paddy wagon intercepted, suspect slain.
Oh no.
And they're still after him. But how am I gonna rescue him now? There's no way Edna's bike is gonna be fast enough to catch up with that paddy wagon. Or is there? At least the rocket part came out of this one piece.
Rocket bike.
All right, I'm coming, Doc. You're still in danger, Doc. I've got to get you out of here.
What's that?
I said you're still in danger.
Never mind. Get me out of here, and we'll talk later.
Don't worry, Doc. I'll get you out.
Be careful, Marty.
I'll be back.
I'll wait right here!
I don't think throwing the hubcap at that would do any good. What's he doing here?
Other side.
Keys. The window shut tight. I don't think throwing the hubcap at that would do any good. I need a distraction.
Leave it to me! Hey, driver! You're driving too fast! Watch how you take those curves! I object to your tone of voice, and I find this seat distinctly uncomfortable. Do you have a pillow I can sit on? Hey, I'm talking to you, driver. Don't ignore me.
You!
Thanks, Doc. I guess that's why they call you the Streak.
How did you know that?
I have my sources. Stand back, Doc.
Marty!
think throwing the hubcap at that would do any good.
Eat lead, Sagan! Ow! Son of a bitch!
I'm fine. But I wonder what sorts of bizarre repercussions my younger self's invention of a flying bicycle will have on the timeline.
Did you know that would happen?
I had a suspicion. I never could keep those rockets from exploding.
So, what do we do now?
Now we get back to 1986 before our interactions with the past inevitably cascade into a calamitous future. Where'd you leave Einstein?
Doc?
He's not in the pound, is he?
No, but I think we've got bigger problems right now.
Great Scott!
I wish I could say that was a lot of fun. It was definitely something.
What's happening?
I don't know. We'll have to be careful not to run into ourselves.
Hey, fellas.
All right, McFly. Let's go see the boss.
History says Tanner will be arrested by a rookie cop by the name of Danny Parker.
I fear that nothing will save Hill Valley from descending into the fires of chaos and corruption.
Nothing is over until Kid Tannen says it's over.
Cool. Well, I'm gonna take a quick break. There we go. Let's worry about levels for now.
I'll be seeing you there.
At least one more in strength. We've done that. Let's cut back across. Let's just get rid of that. What's going on with Switch?
Oh, miracle?
No, nothing is yet.
Come again. The effect.